I think right now, by this point, a lot of companies have a presence on social media. Maybe they started a Facebook page or a Twitter account or a LinkedIn page, but they don't really know how to utilize it in the best way. So my focus is really on telling them a little bit about what the tools are that they can use, but more about how they can use it to build a strategy that will help them get real ROI for their companies. I think one of the most interesting things that I heard yesterday from the panelists that gave case study examples was the importance of incorporating the community into the discussion. And I think a lot of people, when they first get involved in social media, they're so afraid of what the community will say because they don't want to hear anything negative. But the benefits of actually incorporating them, let's say you want to build a community and you need approvals from the community to get through city council. By opening up the forum and listening to what people want, you'll have a much easier time getting your project developed. So I think every single person touched on at one point or another the benefit of actually opening up the communication avenues so that you could have a real discussion. Even if it's online, it's having their voices heard, and that makes a big difference. When clients come, or potential clients come to Maven and ask us about social media, typically what they want is to build a bigger presence online, to increase their brand awareness, and to create some sort of a positive buzz about their communities, projects, developments, et cetera. So what we help them do is first we look at where their audience is, what's the age demographic, who are they looking at, what are they interested in, and that'll help us pick what resources we should be using. Facebook is great, but it's not appropriate for every single type of client. Same with LinkedIn, same with Twitter. Video is pretty universal. Most people should have some sort of video component at this point. But once we take a look at that, we'll focus our resources and the messaging on what's really going to resonate with them. And the point is really to, drive traffic, drive sales, increase awareness. We always ask them upfront what their objectives are, because that'll be really important later on when you go to measure whether or not your program was successful. There's always the big debate about platform versus content. And in our opinion, content's always going to be the most important thing. What you say and how you say it is going to be more important than the tools you use. The tools are incredibly important because obviously if you're using Twitter and you have a great message and none of your clients or stakeholders or investors follow Twitter or care about Twitter or see any of the feeds, you're probably not going to do a great job of impacting their opinion. So it is important, but always, always, always it's content. If you want people to follow you or like your brand or be involved with your company or build advocacy for your project, you need to have a message that resonates with them. So that's always going to be our first priority.